Okay. Oh, well. Oh, jeez. You know, I'm just gonna start here. Hey, everybody. It's kind of frustrating. I went through a large section of the game without saving, and I died. And I started off right at the beginning of where I started the episode last time. I suck sometimes, so get used to it, I guess. But, you watch it. You think it's fun, obviously, so I'll leave it up to you, but I think I'm terrible. I've had a pretty good day today. Why is the mouse still on the screen? Go away. I've had a pretty good day today. I'm tired, but I'm not nearly as tired as I have been most days that I've come home to record. I don't know why. I just got a lot more energy. Which is nice. It's good to be energetic. I'll never fake it with you guys. I'll try to be entertaining, but I hope that I'm more entertaining by just being legitimate than I am by faking it. I don't want to fake happy for the sake of entertainment, but I do hope that the videos are fun for you guys to watch. Okay, back here. Let's save again. This is why I named an episode Jonathan Learns to Save. Because I suck at it. I remember now where I'm supposed to go. And the last time I tried, I couldn't remember exactly where to go, but now I've got a better handle on it. There's actually a tree ability that lets you stay underwater, like breathe underwater, so that you don't have to consistently, you know, try to conserve air, but I just haven't done that yet. Boom. I thought I was going to have a harder time with that, but I guess not. Okay, yeah, this is just a secret area. It's nothing really all that special. Okay, and I can get here a different way later on. So, bad Ori, don't land on the spikes. I had a pretty decent time at work today. I'm having to learn a little better how copyright laws are supposed to work for YouTube, because I actually got called out on it by somebody. I don't even know if I'm, like, allowed to talk about stuff like that. But I got called out by somebody, and I don't really know what I did differently in that video than anyone else has done on their Let's Play videos. Not sure. Ow. Okay, so you will come over here. Lesson learned. Really not a fan of you right now, Rhyhorn. There we go. Just be patient. Map piece. Okay, making progress. That's convoluted. Let's get over there first. Let's check out the other end of this place before I try to make it over to any other section of the game or try to move forward anyhow. I've got the both of those after all, so I might as well. One thing that I'm trying to work on is audio quality. I mean, the biggest thing that I need to work on is learning how to talk and keep things interesting. Maybe I need like a topics notepad where I can, you know, record things that I'm thinking about that I want to say. I just don't have time to do that kind of stuff right now because I'm working two jobs and... Ooh. Oh, yay! I forgot about this tree. I'm glad I came over here. The most powerful ever seen. Now here he rests, turned into an ancestral tree. But yeah, I should really keep a sheet of topics or conversation ideas. Because, I mean, I've got plenty of things I could do. Plenty of things I could talk about, plenty of things that come to mind throughout the day, but... Boop doop doop doop. Got it. But they just don't come to mind when I'm actually playing a game. I love Stomp. Stomp makes everything better. Like, the entire game gets easier once you get Stomp. Those, porcupine slugs, not a problem anymore. Because Stomp was the bomb. See how that guy just died? Just shriveled up and died? That wouldn't have happened earlier. Is that all? No, that's not all. Okay, I need to go underwater. Die! Piranha. Come on, get your hair. Okay, there we go. Get the experience orb and go back. Ooh! Ah, forgot about that, I guess. Where was the other one? Let me see here. Oh, it was all the way at the top. I actually don't know if I can get that one right now. I'll check, just in case. Because if I can, I want to make note of that. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I should be able to do that. Via this dude. I think I should be able to do that by this guy. Or does he only attack me if I'm over here? He does. Okay. Can almost just hit him with his own projectile. Okay, I don't see a way to get it. Oh well. I hope I didn't just royally waste everyone's... Yeah. Oh! Back here again. Okay. I hope I didn't just royally waste anyone's time, but... I was really curious. Boop! See, that's something about game design that really should be noted. Alright, so like, and I've talked about this before, but this is just another compliment for this game, because it deserves all of them. Here, secrets that you can only get to after having gotten the ability that you just received. All sorts of little things like that. That make the game better, make it more expansive. Whoop. But jump up. What? How? How then? How do I do that? I'm really confused. I'm not sure how to do that. How do I get out of here? Yeah, I'm very confused right now. You can't do it like that. I know that much. Why can't I? Oh, my brain is... Either I'm brain dead and I'm missing something really obvious, or... I don't think there's a way out down there. Like, down there? I don't think so. I think this is the way that you get back to where you were, but let me check. I'm sorry this is going to be really convoluted, but I want to know. Can you show me? I want to know how to get out of this. Ooh, spikes. Ooh, doop. Aww. Oh, here again. This episode, man. This episode is not gonna be the best. Let's head down here. But I was talking about copyright stuff before. I don't know how all that stuff works, and I didn't expect to be having issues with it this early in the channel. But I did a let's all play of a particular game, and we didn't, like, I'm pretty sure that everything was protected. Oh, there we go. I'm pretty sure that everything we did was protected by fair use policy. Or by fair use copyright laws, but I'm not sure. Okay, so was that area now... Yeah, that area was emptied out now. Okay. So I can now jump down and smash that area open. Give it one heck of a smash and it'll open up to you. But, Yeah, I didn't expect to be running into copyright issues this early on in the channel. And at this point, the channel has literally 5 subscribers, and they're all my friends. and I posted one video, and I don't think there's even a moment in the video where I infringed copyright laws somehow. But it's been claimed by somebody. I think it was like an auto detection on YouTube's part. And if this happened in this case, I could imagine that it happens to pretty much every Let's Player constantly. Because I don't know of anything that we did that was different than what other YouTubers and Let's Players have done. So, a little confused. But I'll figure it out, I guess. And if worst comes to worst, then I guess I'll just take the video down. I'll freely admit that I don't know how stuff works. But, ability tree. One thing that I gotta work on is that my voice cracks a lot while I'm doing Let's Plays. And maybe it's that I'm just not talking correctly. Oop. Is that really all that's down here? Appears that that's all that's down here. Oh. Well. But. But yeah, I'm not sure about all that stuff. Yeah, there is. Okay, I was curious as to whether or not there was something up there, but there is. And I'm gonna try to get it. I love how well hidden that secret area is. Because there are other secrets that you almost nearly just fall into. Okay, come on, spider. The timing is hard on these jumps. It's very difficult. Very, very difficult. But if you can do it, then it's rewarding. Not incredibly rewarding, because, mind you, it is just a small amount of experience, but... Oh, come on, spider. Yes! Okay. Yeah, you really gotta nick it. Time it very well. Otherwise... You're just not going to get through there. Or get up there. However you want to say it. But yeah, enemies like that, and being able to phase through them is very, very useful. And let's see. Ground pounds. Even if they're above you. So the ground smash destroys their projectiles and hurts them. So it's like the ultimate defense and offense against those porcupine slugs. Makes everything better. Let's see, I'll go for collecting later on at another point. I don't have enough to talk about tonight to really make anything like that interesting. But I can get this one. That one's easy. Boop, boop. And getting through this part is way easier, too, when you have double jump. I actually forgot how much easier it was. Oh, dang. I spoke too soon. You can definitely still die, so be careful, but... let's go up here first. Boom. Wrecked. Then... Oop. Go, cat fox dog. Let's see. Can I get up there? I'm not sure I can get up there right now. But I think I can. Therefore, I will try. I can. Okay, that's good. I don't know. When it comes to copyright issues and stuff, I don't really think about it that much. Like, I just play games to have fun, and I record it so that I can maybe share some of my thoughts or whatever else with people. And, you know, I'm not trying to monetize off of someone else's properties. I'm just trying to have a good time and try to be productive with all the time that I have somehow. And so I don't know. That's fearful. Still hunting the light, blinded by hate. Is that all he says? That is an incomplete sentence, sir. I'm bothered. Oh, wait. Yeah, there was a thing for the ground pound. No, not what I wanted. Right here. Pound it. Pound it. And that opens up the little door, which is very nice. Boom. You see how much easier that is? It's so much nicer. And your average base damage goes up too as you play. Which is cool, I think. Boom. It gets easier to play as you go along, but not so much easier. Never so much easier that, you know, it's not worth taking your time on. It's pretty much like any platformer. Once you have an understanding of how the levels work and all the rest, then it gets easier from there, but never to the point where, you know, you couldn't die. You can always die in this game. I thought I could just go straight up. But, I guess not. Though I do like these jumpy pads. Whoop! Woo! And having the ground pound ability definitely makes the jumpy pads more fun. Because you can jump stupid high! Which I think makes that experience or breachable now. That was almost very painful. Okay. I think I can do it. Just gotta time it right. There we go. Yeah, I've got 3 ability cell points. So I'm gonna go ahead and spend those. 2 ability points, 1 ability point. Awesome. I didn't even mean to kill that guy. I would really love to have a partner on these videos to play with me, but of course I do this almost every day. I don't expect people to have the same degree of, you know, willingness to do it as I do. So I can't expect anybody to participate. I couldn't even, like, expect something like that of any of my friends, because I know they're busy and whatever. Oh, it deflects shots too. I actually didn't know that. I had never noticed before. That might come in handy. Boom. Boom. So easy. Oh man, jeez. Run straight into his spikes. Boom. But yeah, it would be really handy to have someone else here to help me out when I don't have anything to say or something like that. Because one thing I don't have the time to do is edit a whole lot. And if I were to do this alone all the time, I would have to ignore the dry spots and move to an instant where, you know, something more exciting is happening, or when, you know, I've got bigger reactions, and I don't want to spend all my time doing that. Especially not at this point. Like, at this point, I'm just doing this experimentally and just doing it for fun. I don't want to be, like, not that I'm not committed to it. I do like what I'm doing. I'm enjoying it. And I'm enjoying playing video games and having to talk through them because it adds a degree of freshness to the game that wasn't there before. So it lets me enjoy some things that I've played through multiple times as though they're new again. Like this. Like, this is only the second play time I've played through this game. But playing through it from this perspective of talking through it and trying to multitask and being better at the game and being able to play through it as, you know, as it being an easier playthrough. Not that I mind a hard playthrough. Get some air. Go back down. Because I think there's something down here that... Yep, you are definitely worth my while. Another life orb? Gotta get them. Their life cell. I just forget that they're cells. But yeah, it's rough. I actually, I don't know if I've said this already, but I've been... When I chose to start doing, to start putting videos up this week, the week when I'm working two other jobs and have a girlfriend and I'm taking care of that, and like everything that I've got on my plate, because I've already got like at least 13-hour days already. So the idea that I'm adding something else on that, I had to have done that on purpose for a reason. And I am. And the reason is that I want to see how I'll do with the timeline of trying to get something out once every day. And it's already come pretty close a couple times. Instances where I've had to stay up really late to get something done and get something out. Over the weekend, I was actually up on Sunday until 2:45, and I had to be up at like 6 or 7 so that I could get something edited and ready for Monday. How do I... Okay. I couldn't remember how I got up there. Apparently, I still can't remember. Alright, there we go. I'm gonna spend those. This is where the game kind of picks up, because I've gotten a number of abilities that I can use to pick up... goodness. Oh, I need 4 for that. Okay. But I've gotten a number of abilities that I can use to pick up orbs from around the map, and it makes exploration and character progression a lot easier, because you can start picking up and upgrading your character, getting... Oh, jeez! I forgot about that. Okay. The album for this week was Metallica. And it's Monday, so I haven't listened to... I've listened to a lot of Metallica throughout my life, but this is Metallica by Metallica. The actual album, Metallica. and... I don't know. I think I'm a fan of Metallica just because I don't think anybody could not be a fan of theirs to some extent. If you're into modern rock and roll, or modern rock or metal, then you have to at least respect them for the progress that they made in the industry, but even if you may not like them. Like, I think that they were very consistent and not really very creative with their music, but I still respect them for, you know, the work that they did and how that advanced the industry, moved the industry forward. No? There we go. There's no way to not respect Metallica. You kind of have to. No, I was pressing Y. This episode, man. Okay. Let's see. Let me use this guy. Jump over here. But, yeah, I've been really interested because one of the things that I've been doing with this album a week, thing is, one, it's just a way to save money. Like, listening to music, I think, is cheaper than other means of entertainment. And so, it's been fun from that perspective. But one of the things I'm doing with it is actually reading and trying to understand the lyrics of songs that I've known for a really long time, and just have never really deeply tried to understand what the lyrics are saying. Because, like, you can know what lyrics there are, but you won't know what message they're actually trying to give until you study them a little bit. I'm sorry for how much I'm dying here. I don't completely suck, I promise. I hope you guys have seen that. Ooh, that was quite a thud. Boom. Boom. Oh, when you land on an enemy, you bounce. That's nice to know. Learning all sorts of stuff. It is only my second playthrough, so I guess I'll notice things that I didn't notice before, but... There you go. I really don't like those guys. They're so oddly... I'm gonna save. they're so oddly fast, and this angle is oddly frustrating as well. But, like, they don't move around much. They don't seem like they should really be that difficult. But they are. And I don't know why I have such a hard time with them. Oh, yeah. I remember this. Y'all are getting a lot of how to get the secrets in this episode. Wait. Can I do this yet? I'm not sure that I can do this yet. Can I? Because if I can get up there, I can't. I don't think I can. Wait. Because I remember I did this last time. Yeah, if I shoot one of them and I time it just right... Because you're supposed to need a triple jump for this, but if you time it just right, you can get to the end without it. Yeah! There you go. And I've shown you a thing. A thing that took me about an hour and a half to figure out. I was so stumped when I got here the first time. Oh, come on, I was hitting down. Do the... ground pound. Okay. It took me, like, literally an hour and a half to figure that out the first time. But I was committed to figuring it out, so it got done. Oh yeah, that was beautiful. Not bragging, I've never successfully done that before. Bounce on them a few times to... Woo! Almost died to a laser. Boom! Oh, wait. He ran into me while he was flailing and I took damage. I didn't know I would take damage from that. Alright, well, I'm gonna get this, energy cell, and then I think I'm gonna call it an episode. We've collected a ton of stuff, I haven't had much to say. I'm probably gonna go look some things up before I try to do the next episode. Because I have a terrible feeling that this was awfully boring. And I don't want y'all to be bored. I want y'all to have fun in here. But either way, if you liked this episode, like it. If you disliked it, dislike it. If you have feelings that are more complicated than that, then let me know. I want to correct things, and I want to make a channel that we can all believe in. I hope you guys have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you on the next volume of Ori and the Blind Forest with Couch Chroniclers.